Sichuan, this is Zoe reporting to you live from Yibin City. Well, yesterday we have shown you with a massive, very, very unforgettable experience of a massive sea of bamboo. But today, here I am in the downtown of Yibin City. I'm going to show you a different aspect of the city, which is the smartness and also the advancement of the world, how smart this What's up, Sichuan? And if you have any question about the live streaming, about our show, about anything, you can leave your comments and questions on a variety of different social platforms, including Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Signal, Weibo, and also Yangtze. We really look forward to your inputs. Well, today, here I am at this ART Industry Park Station. Well, ART stands for Autonomous Rail Rapid Transit. So in a more commonly, you know, new in words or terms, people would call it smart train or smart rail, or some people even call it trackless tram. So how smart it is. Today, I'm going to take you to a really, really amazing tour of it. It's actually personally my very first time to get on those trains. I really look forward to that. But before that, I also want to show you something that is really unique, and I will bring in one of the guests for today's show. This is Mr. Huang Wanjun. Oh my god, 我以为这是您的小风扇. Actually, this is the drone. At the beginning, I thought this is like a fan or something, but this is the drone. It's so tiny, it's like the size of my palm. It's tiny. Okay, so, 然后这个就是整个无人机了。然后您是用手机操作是吗?
也可以用手机，也可以不用手机。
Oh, so he can either to control it with his phone, the apps in his phone, but also can be, you know, just with this thing alone. 那您给我们展示一下。
那要不然咱们先买票。对，我们去展示一下我们的智慧。那我们先去体验一下智慧，咱们先买一下票。我是应该拿手机是吗？对。然后我进站还是戴一下口罩哈，因为现在这个疫情管控，
so I have to wear a mask because now we're getting inside the station. And for the prevention control measures, we have to put on the mask. 那我们现在买一下票。我们现在是在这一站。这个产业链。Okay, we're here at the Industrial Park Station. This is actually the starting point here. 这是始发站。对。然后我们要去最后一站。高铁已经是站。宜宾站。OK。然后。哪一张是我？因为您是工作人员，您不用了。OK。我用支付宝按单。We're gonna choose the final station. Oh, 我选支付宝。 Okay, I'm gonna choose online payment. And then just scan it. Okay, password, sorry, this is to myself. You can't see it, sorry. Okay, now it's successfully paid. Where's the ticket? 那我们从哪儿取呢？在哪儿？哦，他正在, okay, now the ticket is coming out. Okay, now here's the ticket. So I'll just go from there. Okay. Okay.
健康码.
Oh, sorry. Now she just took my temperature. Also, I need to show her the health code. It's now still very strict here in China for the pandemic prevention control measures.
健康码是吧? 给您看一下。
Still very strict. Let me show you just 1 second. Okay, so now it's green, which means I'm healthy, and I haven't been to any like high-risk pandemic control places, so that means I'm good to go. And now we're inside this platform of the Yibin Industrial Park Station. We're going to take a very, very amazing special tour with one of those, it's called Smart Rail. The official name is like this, it's called ART, Autonomous Rail Rapid Transit. But actually, so many people call it the smart rail or smart train. 大家一般都叫它智慧，对吧？智慧就是智慧的那个智。是的。 In Chinese, this word actually means wisdom. So, how much wisdom does it have, and how smart it is? We're gonna look forward to that. 那我们先看一下，因为其实很多人现在都有一个疑问哦，因为现在看到我们很多的这个观众都是我们的国际友人，就是这个智慧，包括这个叫 smart rail， 他们可能并没有一个很。
很具体的这样的概念，就是到底是有轨道还是没有轨道，还是一个比如说在地底下的轨道，到底什么是智轨呢？黄老师，就是正如您所看到的，其实我们整个智轨的道路上，它是没有传统的那种物理上的那种钢轨的，就像铁轨，
对，就像当当当当那样。
对，没有那种。其实它只是画了两条线，我们看到这两条线。
对。
那么我们就采用这种自动跟随的技术，那我们的车辆就可以跟着这两条画的虚拟的轨道，那么行驶。
就这样子实现的，所以说它叫智轨。所以它其实是没有一个真正的轨道，但是这一条线就是这个我们叫这一个道，其实但是呢是给我们智轨的列车专用的。对。哦，那现在我明白了。So now this engineer told me that actually for why it is called smart rail, there are so many people they just wondered that you know for smart rail, do they really have track or it is trackless or it is something that's put underground? So what is really like? And I asked him is that it's actually there's no track that is put onto either on or beyond the ground. It is just like an exclusive lane to the
绿灯识别系统吗？它是有一个我们的一个调度的一个控制系统，它和我们的交通的控制系统是结合在一起的，就是可以实现我们车辆的这个。
有地铁，然后有公交车，然后有的时候在一些欧洲的比较古老的国家，他们还有一种很古老的有轨电车。那是不是智轨？我听当地，因为我之前也采访了一些当地人，他们说智轨呢有点像这几个东西的综合体。是的，是可以是这么理解。把它叫做开在道路上面的、公路上面的一个地铁。哦。
Oh.
So actually, because before I have talked to some of the local people, and they say it's more like a fusion. Of you know tram, bus, and also train. Let's get a closer shot. Sorry, I have to stop here because now we are seeing a train is coming into the platform. We are seeing one right now. Okay, 是绿色的，好漂亮啊！ It's great. It is so pretty. And Mr. Huang just told me it's more like a train, or it's more like a marshal that's driven on ground. 那我们从这个地方上，是不是？ Okay. So now we're getting on this very special trip. Just follow me.
哎，小朋友。
Okay, cool. Now we're on to this train.
我的第一个感受哈，就是好凉快。
对。
So because now it is so hot outside, it's like 36 degrees outside. I was like sweating so hard, but the first feeling I get inside this car is it's really cool because of the air conditioning.
这个是空调全覆盖的是吗？
对，对，所有的。
全覆盖的，而且是这个车是2019年，
对，2019年
的通车，所以你看整个的装修风格就感觉很现代，然后有你看还是绿色的，就感觉有点可爱。
是的。
Because the train here in the city was launched in 2019, so you can see the decoration, the interior here, I think it's kind of cute. It's really modern. It's also very homey. It's really like a combination of a train, a metro, and a tram. 所以真的是像这个三者结合的，或者像您刚刚说的。就是在整个的这个城市上面开的这样的地铁，
对，
是吗？
对。
哦，哎，我们这个让摄像机往这边走一下哈 ，Let's take the camera to see a little further here。整个的这个车从这儿到那儿是有几节车厢呢？
整个是三节车厢。
Okay, so this I would say this smart wheel has three carriages。从那头到这头，其实我们是可以看到。能带就如果是同时能坐多少人呢？
就是我们最大的设计的容量是307个人。
307个人就是包括坐着和站的。
坐着和站的。
So the maximum capacity for this train is 307 people. That's quite a large number. 这个人还是挺多的。
是的，是的。
因为公交车一般坐就是60-70个。
六七十个。
这是不是60多人？然后这个等于发一趟等于发了差不多五辆公交车。Because we know the average capacity of a bus is usually from 60, 70, sometimes at most 80. But this is like one train of this, like almost equals five, six, seven buses. That's really a lot. Let's take a seat here. 咱们来坐一下。
坐一
会儿。因为我第一次上，所以我觉得好新奇，让我先看一看。It's really my first time to be on a smart train like this. Let's see. I'm really curious about this. It's cool.
平常因为现在这个是始发站，这一站的人一般都不是很多，是不是？
对，就是工业的员，他们还没有下班，就是我们这个乘客。
所以它是工业园区。
对，到了5点之后，我们还要加大这个发车的密度，就是保证这个人员的通行。
比如说现在是一个什么样的频次，然后到了这个交通晚高峰或者是早高峰，它会提高到一个什么样的频次呢？
现在我们是15分钟发一班，到了我们晚高峰或者早高峰的时候就是10分钟一班，后面还会往。进一步压缩这个发车的时间。
哦，是这样。
对。
那一天现在，因为从2019年到现在，可能大概运行已经差不多将近两年了
嘛。对对。
它大概现在提高到一个每天是多少乘客去乘坐这个车的一个量呢？
我们每天这个就是乘坐的人次大概是1.5到2万这样的一个人次。
1.5到2万。
对。
这么多呀。So because the train was launched in 2019.And now, because now it has going through this period of developing, and now for each day, there are on average about 15,000 to 20,000 people commute on this train. 那这个其实对于当地还是来说，还是一个解决了很大的、缓解了很大的交通的一个压力的问题，可以这么理解吗？
是的，是的。就自轨开通了以后，其实对一方面对我们的这个交通的缓解还是非常明显的。就是拿我们长江桥为例。我们现在每个小时通过的那个车流的数量是增加到了340辆车每个小时，然后的话，我们事故的那个减少率就是减少到了98%，
减少了98%，
98%。
就是换一个程度，换一个方法，说法就是，其实它也是一个更安全的这样的一种。因为我之前那个还忘翻。 So actually just now asking because now the frequency of the car is like 15 minutes. Every 15 minutes there's one rail. But now because it's only, it's only like 4:15. Yes, about 4:15 p.m. here local time. But now it's not the peak hour yet. When it reached 5 or even a little bit later, like during the morning rush hour, during the you know, afternoon peak hour, there will be it will be speeding up this this frequency of the train. It's like to from 15 minutes to 10 minutes for each rail in order to ease the pressure for the peak hour. Yeah. 我们感受一下，现在开车了。So now let's really feel it. Now the car is moving. Wow. Cool.
高铁无锡站，下一站盘龙站。列车运行时，请站稳扶好，请为需要帮助的乘客乘坐，感谢您的合作。
Feel free to leave your comments. Feel free to leave your questions on a variety of various social platforms, including Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Sunday Weibo, and Yangshipin. I have my phone with me. I'll check it, and I'll see if I have a time. I'll try my best to respond to that when we get a chance. 因为我们今天的这个直播是在很多个平台，包括Yangshipin，包括Facebook，还有很多海外的平台在进行直播。所以呢，很多网友看一下，有很多的这个问题啊，包括他们的评论。那我们如果有机会的话，就给他们解答。好吗？你看起来很年轻，所以方便问一下您多大吗？
20多岁。
20多岁，但你已经是一个工程师了。
是的，
哦，因为我们这个直播嘛，它是对外的，有很多国际观众。Because I'm telling him that we are doing this live streaming that is mainly focusing on the international viewers. 因为很多国际观众其实对于这个智慧这个概念并不是很熟悉，因为它是一个很比较新的这样的概念。所以你作为智慧的一位工程师的话，你如果像我们的外国友人去讲这样的一个智慧，它最鲜明的特点，您会说哪几点呢？哎，您现在就是这个推广大使，跟我们讲一下。
就是从我个人的乘坐感受来讲哈，第一个是它的一个舒适。然后是准时
，OK，
还有一个是便捷啊，这几个特点。
这三个特点。
对对对。
The first thing is 准时。
对。
Punctuality. That's the first thing that I think is the key or is the most impressive elements about this train. 准时就是说几点到就几点到。
对 对。
不晚点。
现在我们的准点率是在98.5%以上。
这么高啊？
对对对对。
这个不吹牛的是吧？
这个不是吹牛的，这个是有数据，我们是有一个运行图，可以通过那个图里面。算出来的，
因为准点其实对于交通出行的人来说，可以说是这个最重要的因素之一。
是的，是的。
Okay, so he said the first thing that's important is about the punctuality, and I asked him like, you know, there's really real seldom delay about this train. He said yes, actually the punctuality rate of this train 是从2019年开始是吗？
对。
Okay, since 2019 is about 98.5%. That's really, really impressive number because it is based on a large number of database after the train is being operated, put into operation. So that's the first thing, that is punctuality. 第二个因素呢，您刚刚说的，您会这个推荐的，就是因为它很方便。
对，很方便，因为自从我们智轨开通了以后啊，其实就给我们整个市民出行多了一个选择。就是由于它的这个方便，给沿途带来的就是很大的便捷，大家现在都很喜欢坐这个智轨。
第二个呢 so the second thing is convenience. It's really, really bring lots of convenience to people who want to go to travel to different places. To it filled lots of gap between the state, different state stops. 因为之前是比如说很多站之间是没有这个运行连接的。
对。
它其实也填补了一部分交通的这个枢纽的空白，是不是 ？OK. 那第三个因素，您刚刚说的是什么？
一个是
快捷。
对对，快捷。
快捷。
就是从我们的出发站，就是从我们的出发站到我们的高铁云西站，总共只要大概38分钟左右这样一个时间。就相比以前，我们如果是打车过去啊，基本上是1个小时零几分钟。
哦，是吗？
对对对。
哦，那其实花了一大半的时间，或一半多一点的时间。
对对对。
Okay, the third thing that is really, really important to people is that it is really fast. Because from the station that we just took on, which is the starting point, till the end, which is the Yibin West Station. usually if you take a cab, you take a car, you drive yourself, it's going to take over an hour. But now if you take this train, it only costs about 38 minutes. And the punctuality, remember, is almost 98.5%. That's really, really amazing. It is based on a large enough database. Okay, now 我们现在看到很多央视频的这个网友他们在留言哈。Okay, now we're reading some comments from 央视频. We're seeing, 知识就是力量说来了来了. Okay, welcome. And 青青, okay, you smart. Smart. Thank you.但是珠海说的有轨电车是和我们现在做的智轨是一个
不一样，就有很大的区别。
OK， 所以在这儿，我们要说就是有轨电车不是智轨电车。
对，
有轨智轨电车在一定程度上是约等于无轨电车，可以这么理解吗？
可以这么理解。
OK，so、okay, we have to emphasize that smart train or ART is not cable train or it's not like metro. It's more like trackless train because it doesn't have tracks on the ground. 它头顶上也没有，它头顶上有电缆。
没有那个供电的线网。
So it doesn't have electricity cable. That goes beyond the car. So it's more like the opposite. 其实是它的相反的，是有轨电车相反的。
对。
It's more of a equivalent to a trackless train. I would say that. So. 现在可能有很多城市还没有。Okay. This is from 央视频 and we might also have some other feedback and questions from other platforms. Listen, if we have any, I will try to read them. So if you have any questions and comments, feel free to leave them. Really look forward to your inputs. And now we're going through this very, very unique experience trip that's starting from Yichang Industry Park to Yibin West Station.It's called Smart Train, or it's also called Autonomous Real Rapid Transit.、嗯、然后在宜宾这个其实算是全国第一个商业化的智轨电车，对吗？
对，是这样子的。就是我们从2019年的年底开通了全球第一条商业化的智轨线路，那么也就是我们现在乘坐的这条线路。
OK。
对
对。So starting from 2019.Actually, we launched this. This is also the very first commercial line for... Several factors that I think really are the most attractive elements of this train, such as the punctuality, the convenience, and also how fast it is, and also I think the economic price, like the reasonable price, is also one of the factors that play a role. This is amazing. 我们再感受一下这个车。现在我们这个行驶的是什么区域呢？
现在是我们的就是三江新区。是我们宜宾的一个新建设起来的一个城市。
所以这边看着就是比较现代的这样的地方。
对对对。
So we are now more like going through the new area. So we're more like starting from the very, very newly developed area and then to the, like, the downtown, or more like the more originally built city center, right? Okay, now it's the sunshine. It's really amazing. As I said, starting from 2019, this car, 这是全国第一个商业运营的 It's actually one of the China, it's the first commercial line for the smart train here in China. 但是现在其实已经在多少个城市呢？大概很多个城市是不是在中国其实都有了？
对，像我们的哈尔滨，然后西安，还有我们的长沙，一共在的是13个国内的城市都引进了我们这个车子快运系统。
好，现在有十三个城市。
对，有十三个城市。
So now there are some Chinese city, about 13 of them that have adopted this technology.And when we get back, we'll see there's some also international cities and countries that are showing their interest. And as I said, that now today we are taking this smart train starting from the industry park to all the way to the West Station. And because now we know it has been launched for almost 2 years, I really want to talk to some of the local people about how they feel about taking on one of those trains. So let's get to them. 那我现在去看一看当地的这个市民他们的感受，然后看看他们这个高不高兴，看坐这个车开不开心，然后待会儿我们再回来跟您聊，好吗？看到这有一个小朋友，小朋友你好，我们在做一个直播，你愿意跟姐姐聊两句吗？哦，不用啊，好吧，那你好好坐，拜拜。He's a little bit shy. Let's go to some people who might be able to talk. And now we are inside this, it's called Smart Train. And today we'll show you like how smart it is. Does it feel, how does it feel to be on a smart train like this? 哎，小美女，你们俩好。Hello. 我们在做一个新媒体直播，方便聊两句吗？好吗？这个因为我今天是在做一个智轨的专门的体验报道，所以你们俩是经常坐这方面的这个坐这个车吗？
对，基本上天天的。
天天坐，为什么你们是坐着上班还是？
对，上班出行主要是。
哦，你们感觉怎么样？
很方便，很快。
主要那你们最大的感受就是坐这个车，因为你如果是这个是2019年才通的嘛，在之前你们俩是坐什么上班呢？
公交车。
异口同声。
时间会比较长一点。
哦，
然后有了智轨以后，然后时间就明显缩短了很多，就可能以前就是要三四十分钟的时候，然后现在十几分钟就
对
差不多了。
哦，是很久，而且感觉很快很方便，
对，
站也。
So those two, they told me that now this is like, they're like a frequent traveler of this smart train because they mainly take it for work commute. 你们一般是从哪儿坐到哪儿啊？
从那个就智能中端园
坐到西站那边
哦，就等于是哦 ，OK，
家在那边，
其实就是等于是这个坐两头这样坐。Okay, so they are actually more like this, you know, take on from the first stop and then all the way to the last end. And they say it's really, really convenient because it's really fast. Before the train was launched, usually it takes them like more than 40 minutes to get to their workplace. But now, 现在大概二十分钟，半个小时。
20分钟左右就到站了。
And now it only take about half the time. They think it's really convenient and fast. It's and also, 你觉得舒适度怎么样在这个车上呢？
很凉快，
然后比较平稳。
对。So they think it's really stable and also with the air conditioning, it also feels cool. 所以整个的感受还是不错，是不是？点个赞。
非常好。
好吧，谢谢两位，打扰了，谢谢。Okay, so it seems that those two pretty girls, they have enjoyed their trip and experiences taking on the smart train. Okay, I have to be careful because now we are running on this smart train. It's not slow. It's also a little bit going fast. Let's also talk to some of the aunties here. 阿姨，你们好。啊，你们好漂亮。我能那个简单的采访你们一下吗？因为我们正在做一个新媒体直播，我们想那个做一个这个智轨的方面的这个采访，你们方便吗？
方便。
啊，你们打扮。去买漂亮衣服是吗？
对，
好漂亮。你们是好闺蜜是吗？
对，好姐妹，
好姐妹。那为啥今天选择坐这个智轨而不是公交车呀？或者？
样子，
很方便，
又安全，
又哎，
又很
方便快捷智能。
智能，你可以感受到。Okay, so I was asking about how they feel, and they say they are actually good friends. They are going to shop. They are going to buy some beautiful clothes, clearly as they are wearing. And they say they really love it, and they took them all the time because they believe it's really fast, convenient, and also feels so good.
好吧，谢谢阿姨，祝大家身体健康。打扰了，打扰了，谢谢。
Okay, here I also saw two international faces, I would say. So, 方不方便我们做一个简单的采访? Is it okay if we talk for just a little bit? Because we are doing live streaming with CGTN, talking about the smart experiences of living in the city. Well, it would be good to talk a little bit about that. So, do you speak Chinese or English?
中文。
中文。那你叫什么名字?
Uh-huh. Yeah, because from my school to the high speed train station is so far. So
yeah.
If you have to take order a taxi, it will be expensive. So using this one is very good.
Okay, yeah. So where are you going today?
I'm going to the west high speed train station.
Oh, and you're going to take off at that station as well.
Oh,
and then
okay.
Where are you going? Are you taking the high speed train or something?
Yeah, I will go to Chengdu.
Oh, you're going to Chengdu? To
yeah.
Do what? To have some fun?
No, I have.
Hot.
Yeah, not really. I have to go there to work, let's say. To meet some friends.
Oh, to visit some friends
yeah.
There. Good for you. When are you coming back today or are you coming back?
Maybe some days later.
Okay, so you're going to have some fun in there.
Yeah, thank you.
Great, so have a great trip. Thank you.
Thank you.
你待会要去哪儿呀？
我是现在去逛街。去逛街。
逛街。
对，逛街。
哦，逛街是去干嘛呢？
买东西，买衣服。
买东西。
买衣服。
买衣服。我 just like 可以跟阿姨们一起，他们也要去逛街。So she's also going shopping. I just suggest her should go with those aunties because they're going to shop to buy some beautiful clothes as well. 你在中国待了多久呀？
一年八个月，快两年了。
啊，那你的中文就已经这么好了？
一般。
Okay, so clearly she's been here in China for a year and a year and 8 months, and I just said, you know, and her Chinese is so good. She's just so. So you 不仅学会了中文，还学会了我们中国人的这种谦虚。Like, you not only learn Chinese, also learn the modesty of Chinese, right? 你们俩喜欢 ？Do you like staying and studying here in Yibin?
Yeah. 不是，就是我们毕业了，然后比如说我毕业了，然后我要搬去大的城市，比较大的。虽然Yibin 就是很方便、
so、
很舒服，
yeah.
但是城市比较小。
Yeah. 对。But you have the plan to
比较大的城市。
Oh, so she has the plan to move to some other big cities, but also enjoying her current life here. Yeah. Cool. Okay, so good luck. 你呢？你有什么计划？ Are you studying here as a university student? Sorry, it's Chinese and English go back and forth. A little bit confusing here.
Both okay. But English also is also. Maybe after graduating, I plan to maybe, let me say first, search for a job if possible.Search for a job,
uh-huh.
if possible, and if not, then I will just go back to my country.
Yeah,
that's cool. That's the first plan that I have for now.
Okay, I know the food here is really spicy. Are you guys both okay with that?
No. 我辣吃不了。
吃不了辣。你最喜欢当地的食物是什么呢？
清淡的菜。
Oh my god, they don't have any. Okay, because we know the local food is really, really spicy. He asked if them are okay. Okay, so Angel is clearly not okay. She prefers something that's light, like vegetable salad. What about you? Do you like spicy food?
Yeah, I can eat spicy food.
You love it?
Yeah, it's
okay. Name one dish that really, really got your appetite.
Yibin.
One dish. Anything local.
Yibin ramen.
Yibin ramen.
Ramen.
That is so spicy. Did you eat it?
Yeah.
Oh, good for you.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll have that for dinner because maybe you have to try some spicy ones.
Yeah.
But thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Have a great day.
Bye.
Thank you. So just now I was talking to some of the travelers, I would say, that got on this smart wheel. And I think their feedback are pretty positive, I would say. A lot of them said it's fast, it's very convenient. And also, its punctuality is also always on time. That's also important. Okay, let me try to back in here to talk with the engineer of the train. Be careful. Okay, let's take a seat to see. Okay. 我们现在是到了九都路站还有几站我们就到这个终点站了。
对
我们稍微往那边坐一坐，这边光好像会好一点。
对
yeah, 我刚刚去跟的这个客人，就是这个车上的还有外国友人，刚刚我碰到两个外国人，对，然后跟阿姨啊还有小年轻的小美女聊了聊天，整体的我觉得感受都很好
啊，是吧？
这个其实您觉得，像这种技术，它给人其实它从技术上来说是很复杂的技术，但是它给人带来的这种感受，其实是我们乘客的这种非常有形的是可以感受到的东西，是吗？这就其实就是我们说的技术去改变生活的一个好的例子，对吗？
对。
像是什么样的城市，您觉得是比较适合去建智轨的呢？因为像您刚刚说的，有很多像中国有13个城市，那我前段时间也看一些报道，比如说像卡塔尔也有那个多哈，比如说它也是具有这个相关的试点。那世界其他什么样的地方呢？我们先回答第一个问题，就什么样的城市是比较适合去建这种智轨的呢 ？So because we know now China has 13 cities that have adopted this smart wheel, but there are some other cities around the world, not only here in China, they are also showing great interest about this wheel, and they have some of them like Doha. They have had a trial run for the smart train. So, what kind of cities that you think are suitable for building a smart train like this?
实际上啊，就是我先说第一个问题吧，就是我们这个智轨它的应用范围是很广的，像在哈尔滨，我们零下30-40度这样的天气也，
哈尔滨就很冷，
对，
然后呢，像卡塔尔就
非常热，对，
它是可以在这些相对比较高或者比较低的温度下
运
行吗？
对，运行是的。
现在是有这个技术是可以达到这种，
对。
Okay, so first thing is that because like for Harbin, which is in the northeast of China, it's extremely cold in winter. It goes like below, I would say 20-30 degrees Celsius below zero in winter. But for Qatar people, like cities in Qatar, it's really hot in summer. Or throughout the year, it can be as high as 50-40 degrees Celsius in summer. It's extremely high. But the trains, in terms of the technology, it's able to stand both the heat and the also the coldness of the weather, right? 所以这是第一个，就它有技术上的它的一个成熟性，去适应不同的自然条件。
是的。
那其他的还有什么因素呢？
还有一个就是我们。它的就是可适用性非常的广，就是它不需要专门的那种什么桥梁隧道，这对我们整个城市它本身的一个环境要求不是特别的高，就只要有现在的道路，经过一个简单的一个施工改造就可以满足我们一个车辆的需求。
Okay, and also the second thing that's really, really important to apply this technology is that it doesn't require a very, I would say, massive infrastructure building.Like if you want to build a train, if you want to build a metro, you need to build a bridge, or you want to go through the tunnel, which really takes lots of manwork, money, time, etc. But for this technology, it just goes through with what it already has with the city. Because he can understand English, that's why I want to make sure about how he understands about technology. If he knows or knows, that's correct. Because it's mostly about technological terms, so some of them I'm not very familiar with. But yeah, thank you so much for clarifying that. And now we are heading into some of the final stops. 那我们再说一下，因为我知道现在有很多的就是世界其他一些地方的城市。
对，
刚刚这个问题您回答完
了
是吗？对对对。 OK， 那我因为我还很好奇呢，就是现在有很多世界其他不同的这个城市，他们其实也表现出了很大的兴趣，想要去跟比如说中车合作，去在他们的国家他们所在的城市来去建设智慧。
嗯，
现在有像比如说跟中车这个表达出一些合作欲望的这个意愿的国家和城市，是不是也是有一些？
实际上有很多就是国外的国家呀、或者城市到我们这里来参观体验我们的智轨，然后他们的整个感受其实都非常好，给了很高的评价。然后像我们的澳大利亚刚刚您提到的卡塔尔，包括我们的马来西亚这些国家，我们都把车辆就是运送到当地去进行了这个路试实验。然后
在马来西亚也是有，
对对，马来西亚也是有这样的。
OK， SoSorry, I'm just checking the, what they have on Weibo, so I have to translate what you have first. So, Ms. Kwon just told me that not only in Qatar, also in Malaysia, they have this, they have sent their carriage there to have the test run, and the feedback is pretty good. 这个反馈呢是很不错的。哦，还有一个问题大家都很关心，就是建这个智轨贵不贵？比如说比起建高铁或者建一些其他的交通的工具，这个建智铁是贵不贵？比如说跟地铁比是一个什么样的概念？
我给您举一些就是数据吧。这个地铁现在我们统计出来的成本大概是6到7亿每公里，6到7亿美元每公里。然后有轨电车也是在1亿以上。那么我们智轨哈，就现在这条线路折算下来，包括我们建的车辆段，总共就是5000多万每公里这样的一个成本。
那如果我们给一个更加直观的这样的一个比例，就是
大概是地铁的1/10。
这个是在宜宾的这个情况。
对，
如果是在宜宾的话。
对
OK, because it may vary from case to case, it may vary from city to city, but here in this condition in Yibin, actually the cost of this rail is only about 1/10 of the cost of building a metro here. So economically speaking, it's very ideal, where it's much cheaper to build a smart train like this.And I think now we're approaching the final 3 stops. 这其实我们已经是最后的几站了。还有一个问题呢，就是我不知道方便问不问。就是很多人都说这个其实智轨它是在一定程度上是智能的嘛。智能的呢，还有一个就是因为它是有无人驾驶的模式。但是我昨天在我到达这个宜宾之后，它有这个智轨经过呢，我就专门特别仔细的往那个驾驶室看了看。然后我发现好像每个驾驶室里面都是有人的，所以到底是无人还是有人，这个是怎么回事呢？
它是这样子的，就是我们在就是刚刚您看到有那个轨道的地方，它是可以实现这种无人的一种驾驶的。但是由于我们现在是采用的混合路权，就整个道路上还有其他的车辆啊什么的，所以说我们有一个司机在里面监督，当然就是如果司机他如果遇到特殊的情况，他也可以自己驾驶，就比如说我那个线路。那个地方线路无损了，或者是还没有湿化线路的阶段，就可以自动用人工驾驶的模式。
但是现在大多数情况下，就是等于是自动驾驶和人结合，或者自动驾驶结合在一起的一种方式。
是的。
OK, because we know one of the things that is smart about this ART is that it has a driverless mode, which means technologically speaking, that you don't need a driver for the train to go through and to move through the city. But yesterday when I arrived, I saw some of the train pass and look into the operation room. I saw their drivers.I just asked him. He said that yes, now because for safety reasons, we still have one driver for each car, because it's more like a mode of mixed mode, like a mixed mode of self-driving and with the driver mostly about monitoring the operation and the movement of the train.
对。
然后这是一个电车，对吗？
对，它是一个电车。那么我们整个车辆哈，刚刚提到没有加接触网，所以它是用。电池供电的，那么我们整个的充电效率哈，它也非常的快，就是我们充10分钟，它就可以跑整个25公里这样的一个续航里程。
充10分钟，
对，
跑25公里，那整个这个从两头终点站的这个距离是多久呢？
我们整个T1线的线路是17.7公里这样的一个线路，就是
17.7公里，
对，
所以就等于你充十分充一次，
对，
它是可以覆盖到整个的这样的就是这个路程的需要。
对。
Okay, so this is really important because we know this is electric vehicle. It needs to be charged, right? It's like you know the the car that needs oil. So for this car, they only need to be charged for 10 minutes, and then it can run for 25 kilometers. So 25 kilometers, what does it mean? Because for the entire trip of this train, it's only about 17 kilometers. So as long as then you charge for about 10 minutes, you can fully cover the entire trip. You don't need to charge in the middle, you don't need to charge at a certain stop, you just need to charge from the beginning, or just need to charge at the end station, and that's it. And then you can just cover the entire trip. So you just
第一个就是它这个采用的是电，就是用电驱动的技术，它是基本上是零排放的，这是第一个。第二个，它的能耗其实也是非常的低，就我们普通的公交大概是两度电左右每公里，然后我们用我们的车辆做了一个试验，就把所有的功率开到最大，然后负荷开到最满，也就是四公里，但是它就是远远大于三个公交车，就是远小于三个公交车这样子的一个能耗了。
Okay, so it's really environmentally friendly vehicle as well.哎呀，我还有一个小小的请求，不知道方不方便提，就是您刚刚说这是一个它是可以实现无人驾驶的吗？或至少我们能不能就是稍微看一下这个驾驶舱，可以吗？
可以，我们可以看一下，
在不打扰它的情况下，可以吗？
对。
Okay. So now Mr. Huang is going to take us to the operation room. I've never been there, to be honest. But now for the just like.When the safety is allowed, we can get in there a little bit just to check if it's possible to see how the driver operates with the car, right? Okay.
我这边开一下啊。
那我就去看一下。When we get in there, we have to talk a little bit quiet, okay?I have to keep my voice down because I don't want to interfere with the driver because he has to concentrate. And now let my cameraman to give you an idea about what is it looks, how does it feel. 这是我第一次进这个智慧的驾驶舱，好酷啊！
您可以去坐一下。
OK， 再两边，这样比较安全。好的。
对，因为它的路权，我们如果是在独立路权的路段，啊，像这种就是完全独立路权路段，就是自动驾驶的。
哦，这段就已经是独立的路权了。
对。
那我们待会儿是不是可以看到一点这个？
对，待会儿可以看到。现在停站，我们待会儿等客人上完了之后，我们可以看一下。
我们太巧了，正好看
到
一个路权。
对。
So the Mr. Huang just explained to me that for the exclusive lane, if it has the full rides for our smart train, then we can actually realize the driverless mode, which is actually now we're going to have, we're going to see that the driver. It's going to shift to a driverless mode very soon. 待会儿它是会转到无人驾驶。
已经是进入无人驾驶了。
Okay. Sorry, I didn't see that. Okay, now we can see the hands. 现在师傅的两个手都已经脱离了这个安全带。Okay, now we can see both hands of the driver is now off the steering wheel. 然后这个它，但是这个方向盘它有自己的这个转动，就是自己的调节。
因为这个它转弯不是特别的大。
车速也还挺快的。
对，现在是跑到55、54这样的一个车速。
已经五十多了。
对，我们在城市里面就是设计的这个车辆设计时速虽然是70哈，我们在城市里面是给它限制到55的。
OK。
那我们现在在这个红绿灯路口，那个信号就立马变成了。
哦。
对。
So for the train actually has a longer red light period and shorter red light period.For those who are just joining our live stream, you are now experiencing the smart train experience here
in Yibin. And now, because we're so lucky, we're able to get into this operation room. And more importantly, we're now experiencing a selfish thriving period. It's really, really valuable. You can see now the driver's hands, two hands, are fully off the steering wheel. Yeah, because now this lane is exclusive for the smart train, and it's why it is able to get the driverless mode, so the driver can get the hands off and the train just can be operated fully by itself, right?
是我们现在到的是倒数第二站，然后我们可以在这个屏幕上看到整个车周围的情况。这两个其实有点像后视镜。后视镜，对，上面还有一个就是360度的一个环视，它上面还有很多红的、绿的那个灯，就是它的一个防碰撞的一个雷达的一个指示。
There are sensors on that, just like to show you the, you know, the different surroundings, the areas, the environment of the train. 那我们要不然先出去，不打扰师傅了，谢谢师傅。 Okay, so now we're getting out. We don't want to interfere or give too much trouble to the driver. Let's see, let's get out. And now we're coming out for the special operation room. That's really amazing because it is my very first time to get on the train like this. 那我们待会儿是不是得准备下车了？哎呦，要不先坐一下？坐下。因为现在车速还是挺快的，有50多公里，好快呀！您刚刚说38分钟，我还觉得是一个挺长的路，但是好像咱们聊着天儿，然后跟我们这个游客交流，主要是沿路风光也很漂亮，车行驶的也很舒服，所以感觉时间一下子就过了。So as time really flies at the beginning, 38 minutes for the entire tour. I thought, it's kind of a little bit long for the trip to be on the rail. But we talked and we see this beautiful scenery of this train, and also because it feels so comfortable, it's cool, it's very stable, it's very convenient. So it's just time just passed even without like realizing it. So finally,
最后呢，我们再给您一个机会，因为现在我们这个智轨也是在大力的向全世界传播嘛。您再给我们，因为我们现在有很多的国际的网友正在看我们的直播。如果您是作为这个推广大使，或者您作为这个专业的工程师，您再给我们这个我们的智轨，您再给他们推荐一下，或者让大家来体验一下，您觉得在您想怎么去介绍呢？
智轨哈，作为一种新型的一种。 轨道交通，那么它兼具了我们传统轨道交通的一个舒适，然后准时，然后快速这样一个特点。那么又摆脱了我们传统这种轨道交通，它在我们就是天上的线路和地上的轨道这样一个束缚，那么运营也非常灵活，经济性也非常好。对，
我发现你说到这个智慧，您就好兴奋。OK，因为我们是要下站，so I have to get it ready. Sure. So I asked them to introduce and to also to just promote about the smart train. They said this is more like the futuristic vehicle, the futuristic commute that you would have. This is very convenient, it's cool, it's comfortable, it's very safe, and also it's comfortable. So it's very ideal. 感谢您，黄老师，谢谢您的一路的讲解和陪伴，谢谢您。OK，谢谢，拜拜。 So today, as I said, we have taken on this very unforgettable tour, taken to one of those smart rail. It's also called ART, the Autonomous Rail Rapid Transit. And we took about 38 minutes to go through the entire 17 stops. It feels so good. And I think with that, we are going to wrap up today's live streaming. I want to thank you for your attention and for your support. Stay tuned, have more to come for What's Up Sichuan. And that's it for this live streaming. Stay tuned with us. Bye for now.